Ya, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, welcome back to our class Power Systems BEJ 20603. Okay, so in this video we will discuss about chapter 5 power factor analysis. So, we will discuss in details about power factor correction. Okay, in the previous video, in the previous lecture, we already discussed about active and reactive power, number one, and then number two, we already discussed about effect of low power factor. So, in this subtopic, we will discuss about power factor correction, which is how to improve the power factor of the system, because ideally we need power factor equal to unity. We need our power factor equal to 1, power factor equal to 1. The question is how to improve our power factor, okay, to 1. Okay, so basically we have a different types of electrical load. In real, we have a different type of electrical load, which is with different power factor in nature. Okay, for example, we have a lightly loaded induction motor. Basically, the power factor of this kind of load equal to 0.2 lagging power factor. Okay, number two, let's say we have a full loaded. This is lightly loaded. Okay, not full load. Okay, let's say we have a full loaded induction motor. So our power factor equal to 0.8 lagging power factor. Okay, let's say we have a neon lighting equipment. So the power factor between 0.3 until 0.7 lagging power factor. And next, let's say we have incandescent lamps. The power factor basically is very close to 1 or 1, which is we call it a unity power factor. And the rest, let's say we have all types. Let's say we have all types of resistant heating devices. Let's for example toaster, heater, and so on. So the power factor basically is close to 1 or unity power factor. Okay, so look at to this example. Let's say we have a three phase motor. We have a three phase motor. For example, this is the nameplate of the three phase motor from ABB. Okay, this is the nameplate. Okay, from the nameplate you can see the power. Where is the real power? Okay, where is the real power of the three phase motor? Okay, can you determine the real power? Okay, this is the real power of the three phase motor, which is equal to 710 kilowatt. Okay, this is cos theta, cos phi, or cos theta equal to 0.88. basically this is the power factor. Power factor of the motor equal to 0.88. Okay, basically is lagging power factor lah. For the motor, basically actually is lagging power factor. Okay, this is the important parameter that related to our cost. Okay, this is the frequency, this is the rating voltage, and so on. Okay, this is the rated value of the motor, which is equal to P equal to 710 kilowatt, and power factor equal to 0.88, a lagging power factor. Commonly, motor we have a lagging power factor. Okay, let's try this simple exercise. Okay, we try to recall our understanding of the concept of real power, reactive power, apparent power, complex power, and power factor. Okay, for example, from the nameplates, determine the real power. Okay, so you can easily determine real power because real power is given by the nameplate. Okay, what is the power factor? Also given by the nameplate. This is a power factor. Okay, reactive power. How to determine reactive power? So given P and power factor, so you can determine reactive power by solving the power triangle. By solving the power triangle, let's say this is your power triangle given angle, power factor, you can determine angle, given P, so given theta and P, so you can determine Q and S. You can determine reactive power and apparent power. When you have a reactive power, real power and apparent power, you can determine complex power, because complex power equal to P plus JQ. Okay, so you can determine, yeah, try to calculate real reactive power, apparent power and complex power. You can try by your own, okay, by solving the this trigonometry or by solving this power triangle. Okay, given P and theta, cos theta equal to 0.88, so you can determine P. Say for example, if you want to determine Q over P equal to tangent theta, so you can determine Q equal to P times by tangent theta. Okay, so try to, so now you can try to solve for apparent power and complex power. Okay, this is the most important part in this chapter 5, which is power factor analysis. So basically, what is power factor correction? Okay, most of domestic loads such as washing machines, air conditioner and refrigerators, and industrial loads such as induction motors are inductive and operate at low lagging power factor. So although the inductive nature of the load cannot be changed, of course inductive nature of the load cannot be changed, let's say you have a motor, in the motor you have a winding and so on, it will introduce L or inductive in nature due to the winding and so on. So we cannot change the nature of the load, so but we can increase its power factor. So the question is how to increase the power factor. Okay, power factor correction basically is the process of increasing the power factor. Okay, process of increasing the power factor, okay, without altering or without change the voltage and current to the origin loads. Okay, this power factor correction, basically we increase the power factor of the system without altering the voltage or current to the origin load, to the existing load. Okay, so a load's power factor is improved or corrected by deliberately installing a capacitor in parallel with load. So which means that we can improve the power factor by installing the capacitor in parallel with the load. Okay, so look at to the mathematical analysis how this power factor correction can improve the power, the value of the power factor. Okay, let's say we have a inductive load. This is the original load. We have a inductive load. For example, we have a load R and L in series. Of course, we have a current through the load because we have a supply voltage. This one we call it original inductive load. Okay, so first of all, you can draw the phasor diagram of the voltage. Let's say our voltage supply as a reference. So this is a lagging power factor, means we have an inductive load, so our current lags voltage by theta. Okay, lagging power factor. Let's say in order to improve the power factor of this original load, original system, so we need to Okay, again, in order to improve the power factor, we can add the capacitor in parallel with the original load. Okay, we add the capacitor in parallel with original load. So of course we introduce a new current, we call it a reactive current, IC. IC, current through the capacitor, we call it a reactive current IC. Okay, so this is the vector of IC, which is perpendicular with the voltage. This is IC. So of course the new the supply current, the new supply current equal to IL plus IC. Okay, this is the summation of vector IL plus IC. Let's say we have IL. Okay, it remain same with the original load IL. Okay, we have IC, so the total current equal to IL plus IC, which mean that our total current will be smaller, will be less than original current IL. This is the total current of the original load, which basically equal to IL. When we add the capacitor in parallel, so the total current supplied by the source basically is less than IL of the magnitude of the original current actually is reduced. Okay, so the angle between new current, new supply current and voltage also reduced. So from this angle you can determine power factor, because power factor equal to cos theta. So your power factor will be, when your angle will be decreased, so your power factor will be increased. Okay, this is the effect of adding capacitor in parallel to the inductive load. Okay, power triangle of power factor correction. Let's say, okay, for the same with the previous circuit, let's say we have inductive load and then we have a supply voltage. Okay, for the inductive load, for the load we have a real power P, and then we have a theta 1, and then we have a Q1. Okay, lagging power factor, which mean that we have a positive Q. Okay, when we add capacitor, okay, when we add capacitor in parallel, of course we add another Q. Okay, which mean you add QC. Okay, you add QC. This QC basically is minus JQC. So your new inductive, your new reactive power will be reduced, become Q2. When your reactive power will be reduced, your theta will be reduced. Okay, this one we can be analyzed according to the power triangle. Okay, this is the new apparent power after adding capacitor in parallel. We call it a shunt capacitor. Okay, so the theta will be reduced, so cos theta, power factor will be increased. So the question is, what is the value of C that need to be added in parallel with the load? So how to analyze, how to determine the value of capacitance that we need to put in parallel with the load. Okay, so from this power triangle, the new reactive power, which is Q2, the new reactive power Q2 equal to P tangent theta, because P actually is fixed. P comes from the load, is fixed. We just add the reactive power, okay, from the capacitor. Okay, so which means that our P actually is fixed, maintained, not changed. Okay, so Q2 equal to P tangent theta 2 from the power triangle. And then reactive power of the shunt capacitor, reactive power of shunt capacitor QC, which the value of QC, QC actually is the difference between Q1 and Q2. So Q1 minus Q2 equal to QC. So the value of shunt capacitor C can be determined by this equation, because our Q, we know that our reactive power equal to VRMS square divided by XC. So our XC equal to 1 over omega C. So equal to omega C VRMS square. So by solving this equation, we have a QC, we have a QC, already determined the QC. We have a supply voltage, which is V square RM, VRMS. So you can determine VRMS square. So from this equation, you can determine C equal to QC divided by omega VRMS square. So from that, you can determine value of the capacitance and reactive power of the shunt capacitor. Okay, is it clear? So this analysis can be analyzed using power triangle. Okay, this is the power triangle of the power factor correction. Okay, look at to the example 5.3. Okay, for the circuit shown below, calculate the supply current. We have a circuit, supply voltage 600, supply to the load P consists of P equal to 120 kilowatt, Q equal to 160 kilovolt ampere active. So determine the supply current, number one. Number two, determine, calculate the reactive power that needs to be supplied by a capacitor bank, okay, to increase the power factor to unity. So this is the keyword, power factor to unity. What is the value of reactive power that needs to be supplied by capacitor bank or shunt capacitor in order to increase the power factor to unity? Then number three, what is the value of the supply current at unity power factor, which means after installation of shunt capacitor? Okay, let's say our system frequency equal to 50 Hz. Okay, so supply current. So what is the supply current? What is IS? So how to determine IS? Okay, how to determine IS given V? So we have a V, we have a P and Q. So you, from this information, you can determine the complex power of the load. Okay, complex power, we know that complex power, let's say complex power of the load SL equal to VRMS, V supply times IS RMS conjugate. So we have a voltage supply, and then you want to determine current. So this complex power equal to P plus JQ. P plus JQ. So by solving this equation, you can determine current IS conjugate equal to P plus JQ divided by V. Okay, this is a complex number. So by solving, by using your scientific calculator, you can determine IS conjugate. From this IS conjugate, you can determine IS. Let's say IS conjugate, this is a magnitude and this is the angle. So you can determine IS. So this angle, you can change from positive to negative. Okay, inverse conjugate. Okay, so you will get IS, supply current. Okay, so next. Okay, in order to achieve unity power factor, we need to connect a compensating reactive load in parallel with the original load that cancel out the reactive power. So which means that you need to determine the S. Okay, so what is the value of load reactive power of the compensating reactive? Okay, reactive power of the which means that you need to determine the complex power of the compensating load or shunt capacitor. Okay, let's say S C, B, the complex power consumed by the compensating load, then the complex power supplied by the generator to the two loads actually is equal to SG1. Okay, complex power supplied by the generator equal to summation of SC plus SL. This is original load. This is the complex power of the compensating reactive load in parallel. Okay, so to obtain unity power factor, we need ensure that SG has no imaginary part. Okay, now since our SL equal to, this is our SL, is given by the equation P plus JQ volt ampere. So therefore, we required reactive power from shunt capacitor. We need to install the reactive power. Okay, we need to install the reactive power. So in order to ensure that our power factor equal to unity, so you need to supply your reactive power equal to QL. Okay, your QL equal to 160 kilovolt ampere reactive. So you need to supply the shunt capacitor equal to QL. Okay, 160 volt ampere reactive. 160 volt ampere reactive. So your complex power of the shunt capacitor SC equal to minus J. Why minus? Because we have a capacitor. Capacitor reactive power should be minus 160,000 volt ampere reactive. Okay, there is no K here. This is a typo. Okay, this is the complex power of the shunt capacitor. So from this complex power of the shunt capacitor, or from this reactive power of shunt capacitor, what is the value of shunt capacitor? What is the value of C? So you can determine the value of C according to this formula. C equal to QC divided by omega V RMS square. Here we have a V RMS is given by the equation. We have omega. Omega equal to 2 pi F. This QC equal to this value. Okay. 160,000 volt ampere reactive. Okay. So that the new complex power after installation of shunt capacitor, let's say SG2 equal to SC plus SL, combination of complex power from the shunt capacitor plus complex power from the load. Okay, this is a complex power from the load. Okay, plus complex power from the shunt capacitor. So you can get your new complex power of the system equal to P, because our power factor equal to unity. Unity means there is no reactive power. So number 3, you can determine the supply current at unity power factor, because we know that S equal to VI conjugate. V is given 600 angle 0. S, new S is already is just calculate equal to SG2. So you can determine current IS conjugate 200 angle 0, which is equal to IS. This is the supply current. Okay, so thus by correcting the load power factor, we have managed to deliver the active power required by the load, and at the same time significantly reduce the supply current. Okay, we reduce the supply current from 300 to 200. Okay, this, when we reduce the supply current, what happened to the system? That's the benefit, the advantages of the low power factor. Sorry, high power factor. When we increase the power factor, what is the advantage? It will reduce the size of the cable, because when the current will be reduced, when the current is reduced, the size of your cable can be reduced. Okay, to supply the load current, and also required V A rating of the generator. So it also reduce the size of the cable and VA rating of the generator. So the new rating of the generator after power factor corrected, okay, is equal to VS IS conjugate. Okay, this is the complex power equal to VS IS conjugate equal to this value. Okay, 120 kVA. This is the new rating of the generator. Okay, it will reduce the rating of the generator compared to the original one without shunt capacitor. Okay, so look at to the next example, example 5.4. When connected to a 120 volt, which is RMS, 60 hertz power line, a load absorbs 4 kilowatt at lagging power factor of 0.8. So we have a supply 120 volt connected to the load P 4 kilowatt and power factor equal to 0.8 lagging. So the question is, find the value of capacitance necessary to rise the power factor to 0.9. Okay, we try to improve our power factor from originally from 0.8 to 0.9. Why we need to increase the power factor? Number one, we can reduce the line current. Okay, can reduce the line current. Number two, we can avoid penalty from the utility. If we have a low power factor, our utility will penalize through the our bill. Okay, let's say in initial condition our power factor equal to 0.8, which mean that our power factor equal to cos theta 1 equal to 0.8. So our theta 1 equal to, the angle of theta 1 equal to 36.87. So in this question, first of all, you need to draw the power triangle. Okay, let's say you have a P and then you have a theta 1 36.87 and then you have a Q1. Okay, S1 and Q1. Okay, from the power factor and P, you can calculate the apparent power by solving the power triangle by using the trigonometry concept for this power triangle. Okay, so S1 equal to P1 over cos theta 1 because cos theta equal to P over S. P over S equal to cos theta. So P is given. So you can determine S apparent power equal to 5000 volt ampere. Okay, from this S, you can determine the reactive power. Okay, this is a reactive power equal to Q1 equal to S1 sine theta 1. Okay, from the power angle, because sine theta 1 equal to Q divided by S. So you can determine Q1. Okay, after you got S1 and Q1, so your main purpose actually is to increase your original power factor to new power factor equal to 0.95. Okay, so your new theta equal to 18.19 degree. Okay, power factor 2 equal to 0.95. Your new theta or theta 2 equal to 18.19 degree. Okay, will be, which means that your theta will be reduced. Okay, your theta will be reduced. This is your new theta, which means that your Q also reduced. From Q1, you reduce to Q2. Okay, real power has not changed because we just add a capacitor in parallel. We just add a Q, reactive power. Okay, not P, yeah. So that's why our real power has not changed. It remains same with the previous P, but the apparent power has changed as follows. Okay, by solving this power triangle, S2, this S2 equal to P divided by cos theta 2. This is the theta 2. Okay, This is, so you will get S2. Okay, from S2 you can determine the new reactive power. This is we call it a Q2. After we put the capacitor in parallel, so the total reactive power becomes Q2 equal to S2 sine theta 2. This is a Q2. So the question is, how much Q come from the shunt capacitor? Okay, the value of shunt capacitor, KVA rate of the shunt capacitor, basically equal to the difference between new and old reactive power is due to the parallel addition of the capacitor to the load. We call it shunt capacitor. So the QC basically equal to the difference between Q1 minus Q2. This one Q1, eh? This is a Q1 minus Q2. Okay, Q1 minus Q2. Okay, Q1 minus Q2. So you will get a QC. This is a QC. Okay, and parallel capacitance required equal to, you have a QC equal to VRM squared divided by XC. So you can determine capacitance, the value of capacitance. This is the KVA rating of the capacitor. And then this is the value of the parallel capacitance, the value of parallel capacitance. Okay, C. Okay, so you can determine QC and C. Okay, I hope you can understand. This is important part of this subtopic. Okay, next, okay, to the last example, example 5.5. Let's say we have a three phase. Let's say in the previous example we have a single phase system. Let's say we have a three phase 5 kilowatt induction motor. This is a 5 kilowatt induction motor with power factor equal to 0.75 lagging power factor. Okay, what is the size of capacitor in kVAr is required to improve power factor to 0.9? Okay, so the question is, what is the value of capacitor need to be installed in parallel in order to improve power factor from 0.75 power factor to 0.9 power factor? Okay, so first of all, what you need to do, you need to draw the power triangle. Okay, for the original load, you have a power factor equal to 0.75. So theta 1, how to determine theta 1? Theta 1 equal to inverse power factor. This is a missing power factor. This is power factor 0.5, inverse cos 0.5 equal to 41.41 degree. Okay, 41.41 degree. Okay, so you have a P. Okay, you have P, and then you have a theta, so that you can determine Q. You can determine Q because Q equal to P tangent theta. Okay, P tangent theta. Okay. Okay, you want to increase the power factor to 0.9. Okay. Okay, you want to increase to 0.9. Your theta 2, this is your theta 2. You type put, this is theta 2. Okay, equal to 0.9. So what is the value of theta 2? Okay, theta 2 equal to 25.84 degree. 84 degrees, typo, similarly to this one, typo. Okay, degree. Okay, and this one also degree. Okay. Okay, so this one theta 2, which is smaller than theta 1, because the small theta will be high power factor because cos theta, yeah. So Q2 equal to P tangent theta. Q2 equal to P tangent theta 2. So then from this information you can determine Q2. Okay, so what is the required capacitor kVAr in order to improve power factor from 0.75 to 0.9? So required capacitor equal to QC equal to Q1 minus Q2. Okay, sorry, this is Q1 minus Q2. Okay, so what is the value of Q1? Q1 equal to P tangent theta, P tangent theta minus Q2 equal to P tangent theta 2, P tangent theta 2. So you can get Q, you can get QC. This is for three phase. Okay, rating of capacitor connected in each phase. So you can divide it by 3. So you can get the value of shunt capacitor for each phase equal to 0.66 kilovolt ampere reactive. Okay. So, I think that's all for this topic. So, you can try exercise 1 and exercise 2. Okay, for this chapter, we have exercise 1 and exercise 2. So, you can try all the exercises in this slide, in this topic. So, I think that's all for this topic. So thank you very much. Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.